Chandragarjan, Assistant Professor at ITICT Department of LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. Welcome to the 7th lecture of Unit 4. In previous lecture, we have discussed about the requirement modeling in which elements of model of sequence diagram. Okay, so we are discussing about the elements of requirement modeling in which we have already discussed about scenario based model, a use case diagram, and in behavioral diagram, activity diagram, streamline and sequence. Now in today's lecture, we will continue with the another behavioral model, that is a state diagram. State transition diagram is basically a collection of events and state. A state diagram is a graph whose nodes are state and whose directs arc are transition between that particular state. So it describes changes in state in a procedure. So if I am switch on a light, then it's a on state, and if I am switch off the light, then your light will be on a off state. Okay, so that will be a state, either on or off. So similarly, in your system, you can define a state diagram by identifying that in which state your system is. Okay, so state diagram is also known as a state chart diagram or a state machine diagram. It specifies the state sequence caused by your event sequences. Okay, so here state sequence is defined by event sequence, and a state diagram is standard computer science concept that relates event and state. So what is the event and in which state that particular event is occur, that will define in a state diagram. So here event represent the external incentives and state represent the value of object. So a state diagram represent what action to be performed on occurrence of a particular event. Okay, so what are the action performed at particular event or particular time, that will define in a state diagram. Now you can see that like all objects in a class execute the state diagram. Okay, so all the objects which are mentioned in your state, they can easily access a state diagram. Okay, so all object in a class execute the state diagram for that particular class and which model their common behavior. So state, that means a condition or situation during the life of an object at which time it satisfied some condition and performed some activity or wait for some particular event. So we can say that a state is a condition or any a situation. Okay, so which condition are satisfying and what activity is performing or wait for some particular event, that will be your state. So a state diagram to describe the behavior of a single class according to the event and messages which class send and receive. Okay, so that will define by a state transition diagram. Now you can see in a image display a state. Okay, so a state diagram can also clarify a use case. Okay, so for use case, you have to specify the action the use case can take in accordance with varying condition of the system. So if I have a multiple different conditions, then I will put a state, like if this condition is performed, then your system is in this state. Okay, for an example, use case about a enrollment of any course. So the state of that particular course, that will be like either that course is a full, like open, or any closed course. Okay, so if you are using any Coursera or edX, then a course have a full strength or open for all and for closed for particular registration. So this will be a state of particular enrollment of course event. Okay, so the UML notation for a state diagram is a rectangle with object name in a small pentagonal tag in the upper left corner. So you can see in image there is a rectangle. Okay, so rectangle box is there and a pentagonal tag in the upper left corner of that rectangle. Okay, so Now let's discuss about the various components of a state diagram. A state diagram have a typically of 5 components, that is a initial state, then final state, then actual states, then transition or event, and a guard condition. So what is a particular component? So before understanding all the components, let's discuss a simple state diagram. Okay, this diagram define a state diagram for any inwards. So here solid black circle is there. Okay, so this will be your initial state. Then if inverse is created, then it will be in a unpaired state. So state will define in a rectangle box, okay, by a diagonal corner. Okay, so this will be an unpaired state. Then if you are paying, so here a transition is between unpaid to paid. So your state is changed from unpaid state to the paid state after completion of your payment. And last, your invoice is destroyed. So this is the final state. So you are initializing your state, then followed by a different state and transaction, and last is the final activity or a final state. So what is the initial state? So each state diagram must have one and only one initial state. Okay, like this is not similar to the activity diagram. In activity diagram, we are mentioning that activity have one or more than one initial activity. But here in state diagram, your state will be in a single initial state. So each state diagram must have one and only one initial state. And notation for start state is filled solid circle. Then final state. So an object can have a multiple stop state. Okay, so initial activity will be one, but you have a multiple final state. And notation for that final state is a bullseye. Similar in an activity diagram. So a solid circle in a inner side and outside a simple circle. Okay, so these are the components. Then next component is state itself. Okay, so a state is a condition during the life of an object when satisfying some condition, perform some action, or wait for any event. Okay, so the UML notation for a state is a rectangle with a rounded corner. You can see in a image. And state name must be unique within the scope of the state diagram. Okay, so you can't give a similar name to do two different state. Like if I am thinking the same name for switch on and off, like if on state there will be on, and if on again then there will be a off state. Okay, so that might be a conflict. So a state name must be a unique within the scope of the state diagram. Now next component is a transition or an event. So it is drawn as a line from the origin state to the target state. Okay, so unpaid to paid. Okay, so in unpaid or simple arrow line, that an overhead point to the target state. Okay, and similarly in a guard condition, you are defining a condition beside the event. Okay, so guard condition is a boolean expression that must be a true in order for a transition to occur. And a guard transition fires when its event occur, and optionally listed in a square bracket after an event. You can see in an image that a guard condition is defined in a square bracket. So condition is written between a rectangle or a square bracket. Okay. So now what are the steps that will be followed to draw a state diagram? So first of all, you have to identify the important object. So what are the important objects in your particular system? That will be your step one. Then in next step, you have to identify the possible states in which the object can exist. Okay, so what are the possibility of the particular state? That will be defined in another second step. Then step three, you have to identify the initial state. Okay, so from which your state diagram will start and at which condition your state diagram will finish. So you have to finalize your initial state and final state during step 3. And for step 4, you have to label the event. which trigger this transition. Okay, so these are the four steps. You have to first identify the object, then you have to identify the possible state, then what are the initial state and what are the final state. Okay, and then after a label the event which trigger this transition. So let's move to the library management system. Here our important objects are like book or CD or DVD, like newspaper, librarian member. This will be our object. Then if you are identifying the state, so what are the state for book issuing? So either book is available or issued or return or renew. This will be a state of particular book. Then you have to identify the event or transition, like book issued to particular user, like book is submitted by the member or request to issue the same book, like renew. Okay, and completion of exam or end of the semester, you are returning the book to the library. Okay, so this will be your event and transition. Clear? So now let's draw the state diagram for library management system. So you can see that there is an initial state. So all the state diagram is mentioned in a rectangle by a corner pentagon. Okay, so book is defined. You are going for a particular book object. So book initial state is available. Book is available. Okay, so if book is available, you can issue a book to any member as a librarian. Okay, so book issued to user. So it is now available to the issue state. Now if member request for a renewation, then from issue to request to a renewation, and if librarian renew that book, then book is issued to the same member. Okay, so this will be a available state to issue state and issue to renew state. Now if member does not require book for more time, then he or she will return the book. So now issue to the return state. So after completion of exam or after your time period is passed, like librarian will inform you before that, like you have to renew book or you have to return book within a 15 days. Okay, so for renew, so renew state, and if you are returning book, then a return state. So after completion of exam or book number of days is completed or a course is or semester is completed, then you are returning your book. And if you are returning a book, then again a book is available for other members. So these are the various states for a particular book. So either book is available or issued or renew or returned by the particular member. Okay, so this is about a state diagram for library management system. Now let's take another example of state diagram of a bank ATM. Okay, so what is the initial state? Initially a ATM is turned on. Okay, so after the power is turned on, ATM performs startup action and enter self-paced state. Okay, similarly in your computer or a laptop. So initially your laptop or computer system is switched on. Okay, so you are turning on that system or your powering is turned on. Okay, so what will perform? So it will perform a startup action. Okay, like self-paced, like keyboard, mouse are working or not particularly. Okay, so ATM is initially turned off, and after the power is turned on, ATM performs a startup action and enters self-paced state. Okay, so if the test fails, now if the test fails, ATM goes into the out of service state. Okay, and otherwise if test is successful, then trigger is less transition to the ideal state. Okay, and in this state ATM wait for any customer for interaction. Okay, so here after self test there is a two condition, either fail or a succeed. Okay, if fail, then ATM goes in the out of service, and if pass or succeed, then ATM will wait for a customer for any interaction. Now ATM state change from ideal to serving customer when any customer interact banking or credit card. Okay, so if I as a user inserting my ATM card into that ATM machine, then ATM state will change to ideal state to the serving customer state. Okay, so the entry action read car is perform. Okay, so once we have inserting our card into that ATM reader, then it will shows a message like we are reading your card. Note that the transition from serving customer set back to the ideal state could be triggered by a cancel event, as the customer could cancel transaction at any time. So if I go for a withdrawal money, but during the transaction I memorize something else, then I will cancel that process. So ATM machine will goes back to the ideal state. Okay, so if I cancelled my transaction, then it will automatically change their state to serving customer to the ideal state. Okay, so now if it is serving any customer, so serving customer state is a composite state with sequence of sub state, customer authentication, then selecting transaction and transaction. Okay, so in your state diagram, serving customer state is a different sub state. Okay, so for better understanding, let's discuss with a proper state diagram of ATM. So here rectangle box, by defining a pentagonal at the corner upper side, like bank ATM, we are defining the name of that particular state diagram. Okay, so initially ATM machine is a off state. Okay, so off is a state. Now if you are turning on that button, then if automatically self test will take place. So if you are turning a button, self test will occur. So if successful, then your ATM machine will be change their state to off to an ideal state, and if self test fails, then your ATM machine will goes to out of service state. Okay, so after turning on your ATM machine, self test will occur, and in self test either fail or succeed. Okay, now if we consider that our ATM is in a ideal state, then if it goes for maintenance, like there is a deficiency of money, then a person from bank will come and put the money into that ATM machine. So ideal to maintenance state. Now if maintenance will fail, then it will direct to the out of service. So here maintenance fail, then out of service. Okay, and if complete, then it will restarting. Okay, so if we are doing any updation in our mobile phone, we are restarting our phone for better performance. So similarly, after maintenance is done, we are repeating a self test. So similar self test, either success or fail. Okay, so this is about a simple state diagram, like off to on state and on to ideal. Now a customer is come to interact and for withdrawal money. So here serving customer is a sub state of that particular state diagram. So in serving customer, initial activity is customer authentication. I am inserting my ATM card into that machine. They will authenticate, like by checking this is the working ATM card or a not. Okay, so customer authentication, then followed by a selecting transaction, either withdrawal or cash deposit or mini transaction or password change services. Okay, so selecting the transaction, and next is a transaction perform, and the final state will complete. Okay, now in between any problem is occur, like any power cut. Okay, so that will leads to the failure. So failure leads to the out of service state, and if it is success, so ideal to card inserted state, so that will be your serving customer. And if any customer cancel, then again your ATM machine will go to the ideal state. And if I am completing my full transaction, then later on I will remove my card after completion of my transaction, so it will again goes to the ideal state. Okay, so here off, self test, maintenance, ideal, out of service, these are the main state states for bank ATM. And another sub states are serving customer, in which customer authentication, selecting transaction and transaction. So this is all about a state diagram of any bank ATM. So बेसिकली अ स्टेट डायग्राम डिफाइन अ स्टेट ऑफ पर्टिकुलर ऑब्जेक्ट. ओके सो सिमिलरली इफ आई परचेज एनी न्यू फोन देन I will put on, okay, so I will turn a power on button. So, from off to on state. Then, I will update my all applications. Like, self-test will occur, like Android or any Apple phone. Okay, so self-test will occur and then after few minutes, your phone will start. Okay, so if I am updating any application, then it will goes to the maintenance. I will restart my phone. Okay, and if this will not work properly, then your phone will be go to the out of service state. So similarly, a bank ATM will work. So state diagram define a different state of particular object or particular person. So in which state a particular object is there, that will define in a state diagram. Okay, so this is all for the today's lecture. Thank you.